Welcome to the SAP ABAP training program. In this video, our objective is to have a quick review of the data object data type. We will understand what is the significance of data object, and we also will understand what is the significance of data type. And we will introduce what is a structure and interval table in a SAP ABAP course. Now, when we say data object, this data objects, when we talk about what is this data object, it defines a temporary memory space in the application layer, in the work process of the application layer. So to do any programming in the work process, we need to define a data object. It can be three types. One is elementary, it can be local, it can be global. So data objects, to define this data object in the work process, so we need to take, we defining a data object one, we can have another data object. So here I can write name, I can write phone number. So the data object will be different data objects I can create, and the type of content which is there, like name is a character. Phone number, it is a numeric character. So all these contents define the data type. So we have two terms here, data type and data object. Data objects, what we are taking, defining a memory with the name of, by using any variables, I can go for a variable. We can define with the name of literals, with text symbols, constants, and predefined variables. These are the terms. So predefined, which is a system variable, palace hand data, it's already there in the system. And variables, this is the thing which is maximum used, like you are using a variable with a keyword data or static, we can define different variables. We will discuss about the literals, text symbol, and the constants. So we are defining the variable over here, or we are defining the data object over here. The type of the data object, ye kya hai, like character hai or numeric, whatever type. Based on the type, it does the processing. Which does the processing? Work process do all the processing in the application layer based on the type, and accordingly the program works. Now inside it, there is a term called literals. What is this literal is? Literal can be defined in three types, like numeric literal, text fields, and string fields. I mean, numeric literals, what is that? It is a fixed attribute. Yani aap isko kisi variable mein nahi define kar rahe ho, it is having a fixed attributes. And these are called unnamed data object. Matlab aap data object ka naam nahi define kar rahe ho, unnamed. Mention here unnamed data object aur ek hai named data object. जो अननेम डेटा ऑब्जेक्ट है, मतलब उसका नाम नहीं डिफाइन किया. जैसे एग्जांपल है WRIT, राइट, देन आई एम राइटिंग 23 विद अ डॉट. सो दिस इज कमिंग इन द न्यूमेरिक, सो आई एम यूजिंग इट लाइक 23, आई एम राइटिंग इट पुटिंग ऑन द स्क्रीन. टेक्स्ट फील्ड्स आर लाइक हाय रोहित, आई एम राइटिंग एंड विद एपोस्ट्रोफीज एंड देन वी आर राइटिंग डॉट. एंड स्ट्रिंग फील्ड्स with the back apostrophe, we can write hi Rohit, and the space we can give. So there the space is considered in the text field, the space is not considered. So I have got a maximum of 255 characters, characters here also maximum 255 characters. So that's way, a literal is of three type, that is a numeric, dusra ho gaya text fields, and another is string fields. Aise karke hum literals de sakte hain. और कांस्टेंट हो गया, कांस्टेंट में आपको डिफाइन करना पड़ेगा. जैसे हम n num एक कांस्टेंट ले लिए, हम डिफाइन के ये कि पैक नंबर है, तो डेसिमल का भी थ्री डिजिट डेसिमल है, तो हम इसमें थ्री डिजिट जैसे 123.245 आई एम डिफाइनिंग लाइक थ्री डिजिट डेसिमल नंबर. सो दैट वैल्यू इज नाउ पुट इन n num. तो ये प्रोग्राम के बाद भी ये वैल्यू इसके अंदर रिटेन करेगा. प्रोग्राम के अंदर अगर हम सब प्रोग्राम है, अगर हम एक वेरिएबल डिफाइन करते हैं, उस सब प्रोग्राम के बाहर भी जाते हैं, तो वो वेरिएबल में 123.245 रहेंगे. सो दैट इज हाउ द कांस्टेंट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. इट इज सजेस्टेड यू यूज ए कांस्टेंट एंड नॉट अ लिटरल्स. But whenever required, a fixed attributes with no certain, just a values to be written, like any content or any word. So we can write a numeric text field and string field literals. दूसरा named name data object में हो गया आपका, जैसे you have a name data object ना, तो inside a name data objects हम लोग हो सकते हैं जैसे constant we have studied, the constant is there. और दूसरा हो गया अपना text symbols. These text symbols are like headings. तो any program is a heading or selection text are the text elements. And then we write a command, write text with a hyphen 001 or this is right 002. We can define with a text number and these are like a heading. And this is always a data type is C. So that's why we can have a name data object can be of like a constant and text symbols and like this. And we have got another is constant that we have already discussed. So that's why we can call it a name data object, another is unnamed data objects. Another is we have just talked, there is a predefined data objects. So predefined data object kya hoga, jo pehle se system variable hai and is usually having a starting with sy. So sy hyphen, then we can have the name which is already defined there in the system. So these are the system variables. So it the structure is also defined by in the system variable. Now we can have a variable. Variable is that mostly we are using in the programming. So here count is a variable which is integer type. Now again we can say count is a variable which is integer type, value is 10 with a dot. Dot represents the end of the programming. So so here variables and predefined data object is important. So now if I just a quick review of what we have done. So data object we have just learned. Data objects can be predefined. It has can be predefined. Your palace symbol has system variable. It is there. Another is variables type. Another is literals. We can have a text symbols. We can have a constant. So we can have these are the different data objects that we can have. Now after the data object gone, so what is we have is data object is over. So we important part is data type. मतलब data object तो हमने define कर दिया, उसके अंदर कौन सा type का चीज है वो important है. Then this important is a numeric, it's a character or it is alpha is character numeric or whatever the value that is important. For that the data type is like predefined. जो पहले से डिफाइंड है सिस्टम में प्री डिफाइंड डेटा टाइप, अंदर इज लोकल डेटा टाइप एंड ग्लोबल डेटा टाइप. लोकल मतलब आप वो डिफाइन कर रहे हो बाय यूजिंग अ सिंबल और बाय यूजिंग टीवाईबी टाइप एंड यू कैन डिफाइन एनी लोकल डेटा टाइप टाइप्स. एंड इन ग्लोबल डेटा टाइप इट हैज टू बी डिफाइंड एंड केप्ट इन द एबैप डिक्शनरी ऑब्जेक्ट और एबैप डिक्शनरी टाइप ग्रुप. So if we define in the ABAP dictionary, so it is a global data type. If it is locally used, it is local data type. And local data types that you will create of your own, matlab ye aap jo create karna chahte ho, then it has to be created through the predefined data type. So predefined data type will be helpful to create a local data type. And if you want to store it always there in the for use for your friends and others, those who are using the programming, your group, so you can define that in the ABAP dictionary object. Now let us take about the ABAP data type. So what are the ABAP data type? Usually I mentioned here that is predefined data types. So ye hum log pehle broadly we have discussed. So now let us have a quick look. It is a fixed length, it is of another, it is a variable length. Fixed length mein aapka character type ho gaya aur numeric type ho gaya. और वेरिएबल लेंथ में आपके होंगे आपके स्ट्रिंग हो जाएंगे एंड एक्सट्रिंग्स हो जाएंगे. एक्स रिप्रेजेंट्स फॉर हेक्साडेसिमल. इन द कैरेक्टर टाइप यू हैव गॉट फोर डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर टाइप्स. वन इज योर एन फॉर न्यूमेरिक, सी फॉर कैरेक्टर, डी फॉर डेट एंड टी फॉर टाइम. तो यहां पर जो टर्म दो चीज यूज किए हैं, इनकम्प्लीट एंड कंप्लीट. आई एम कमिंग टू इट. So let us check what is a data type जो हम data object define कर रहे हैं उसके अंदर जो content है वो content के बारे में हम decide कर रहे हैं. वो content may be or different contents are there, right? So these contents, what is the type of these contents? They are can be predefined, पहले से define किए गए हैं. N for numeric character, like your phone number. तो उसको हम न्यूमेरिक कैरेक्टर में देंगे. सी इज अ कैरेक्टर, यू कैन राइट एनी टेक्स्ट कंटेंट, हाय हाय हेलो हाउ आर यू. देन डी स्टैंड्स फॉर द डेट, टी स्टैंड्स फॉर द टाइम. Similarly, in case of numeric, you have got I for integer, F for float, P for pack number, right? A pack number where you can define what is a decimal content of it, and then you can write a decimal content. X is for hexadecimal, and then hexadecimal is also, we have discussed the numeric characters. So these numeric characters and the character numeric, another is character. The numeric, it can have like two part. One is the incomplete and complete part. The circled one is what you see. The circled one is N, C, and P and X. These are incomplete. That is, the length is there. Fixed length is there, but you can you have to define the length. You can vary the length depending on the requirement. Whereas a date, time, integer, and float, it is of fixed length and it is complete. You need not to define the length of the integer of day, length of the float. So it occupies a memory space, and based on it, maximum whatever the integer value you need to insert or add or do any multiplication, you can do with it. So this is the concept about the data type. Now, the most important part is here that you, once you have a ABAP data type आपका defined है, तो उसको लेकर आप क्या कर सकते हो? You can create your own local data types. आपने अपने एक नाम क्रिएट किया, लाइक मैं एक डेटा टाइप्स कैरेक्टर हम डिफाइन करते हैं ना, तो हम लोग डिफाइन किए जैसे S underscore name. I define this as a one of the data type. ये C stands for character हो गया, तो यहाँ पर उसके कुछ लेंथ डिफाइन है, तो यहाँ पर लेंथ डिफाइन कर दिए 10, और we can define in this case in local data type aap define kar sakte ho s underscore name. So you can make any combination with the underscore and numbers like s1 underscore name. So you can create another data type. So like this, I have just created two data type. I have to define it. So define kaise karunga? Define karne ke liye main usko character define karunga. C type hoga. Kitna, suppose isko 10 diya, C yahan par 30 diya. और यहाँ पर सपोज मैंने इसको 50 दिया, 50 कैरेक्टर डिफाइन किया. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स, दिस नेम, S1 नेम्स, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आई कैन क्रिएट दैट आर कॉल्ड लोकल डेटा टाइप. और वो कितने कैरेक्टर के हो सकते हैं? 30 कैरेक्टर. लाइक S अंडरस्कोर नेम अंडरस्कोर सिटी, आई कैन मेक अनदर लोकल डेटा टाइप. तो इसमें कीवर्ड्स कैसे यूज होते हैं? TYPES टाइप्स यूज कर सकते हैं, एंड वी कैन यूज टाइप एंड लाइक. मतलब सपोज मैंने एक डेटा टाइप यूज किया है S अंडरस्कोर नेम IJD, और मैंने I can define इसे data type की, ये हो गया मेरा S underscore employee underscore IJD. तो I can define different this type of different local data types. And if I have created one data type, now my friend can also use the same data type, or my the co-worker project group can also use the same data type by using the like statement. So he can define his own like S underscore name, and he can put another like IJT or any other institution, and then he can use this that data type is same as the data type which is already created. तो अब तक हम बात कर रहे थे कि हम एक ऑब्जेक्ट लिए और उसको उसके ऑब्जेक्ट को लेकर उसके अंदर जो कंटेंट है उस कंटेंट को हम डिफाइन कर रहे हैं by using the data type. Now if I am using a merge the two objects, like if I have name, I am using two objects. Let us say we meet a field 1. I will say field 1, another is field 2, another is field 3. If I have got a three fields I have, let me just draw it once again. Suppose we have let us go to the structure. Suppose instead of having one field, I need now, I'm not required only the name. I need the name, address, and then phone number. So I have got a field 1, and I have got field 2, I have got field 3. So I have got three different fields. Okay, let us go for the next video in part 2.